Good morning, guys. Are you able to hear me?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, your good morning. Voice is very low.
My voice is very low. Could you please confirm now? Is it okay?
No, sir.
No. Confirm. Please come from audible.
Now it is okay.
No.
No, sir.
So are you able to see the screen? Tanvi, could you please confirm?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. So I hope you are able to see the screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So can anyone tell me what we have discussed in the last class? Can anyone? Yes, please respond.
Mass action law.
Yes. Can you tell me about mass action law?
N into P is equal to NI squared.
Okay. Can you elaborate each and every term? What does N and P and NI mean?
N is number of concentration of electrons and P is concentration of holes.
Okay. And what is meant by intrinsic carrier concentration?
When it is in equilibrium, we call it as intrinsic.
Okay. And what is meant by intrinsic?
Yes, sir.
What is meant by intrinsic and what is meant by extrinsic?
Intrinsic is a pure form of semiconductor and extrinsic is a pure form of semiconductor.
Okay. How many types are there in extrinsic?
Two types.
Okay. What are they?
N type and P type.
Okay. How N type materials are formed? How N type materials are formed? Anyone? Is it because of fifth group elements or third group?
Sir, your voice is
by dropping fifth group elements.
So what we know is we know there are two types of groups, fifth and third.
Third group.
What are the elements that are present under fifth group?
Arsenic, bismuth, antimony.
Okay. And what about the third group?
Boron, gallium, indium.
Good, good. So in the last presentation, we have discussed about mass action law, and it tells us under equilibrium, the product of N into P is N I square. N is something which we call as concentration of electrons or holes.
Electrons.
N is concentration of electrons. P is concentration of
holes.
Right. So you know about Ni, intrinsic carrier concentration, and it is something which depends upon temperature. And here, can anyone tell me what does this mean? E G naught means
energy gap.
So what you know, E G stands for. And what does this not means? Energy gap at 0 degree Kelvin.
Zero.
The zero indicates 0 degree Kelvin. Okay. And one more question: how to convert centigrade to Kelvin?
Adding.
Plus
273. Suppose if. How to add to make it? Good. 27 plus 273 is something which gives us 300. So I hope you are clear with this concept. Next, we have discussed about charge densities also. So are you clear with this concept? Like, what is meant by total positive charge and total negative charge?
Yes.
And rule number one asked one beautiful question, like why we are considering ND as positive one, why not negative? Can anyone answer me this question? Why
because
considering
positive
ND
is
as...
donor and negative is and negative is acceptor.
Good. So negative is something which is acceptor, and at the same time here small n indicates electron. So this is negative in nature, whereas P is nothing but hole, which is positive in nature.
Positive.
So that's why if you are considering total positive equal to total negative, so ND plus P is something which is equivalent to Na plus N.
Okay.
Now, if you want to derive the expressions for extrinsic, under extrinsic, what we know, there are of two types. One is N type and P type. So here, if you see under Na, N type Na is equal to 0. Can anyone tell me why Na is equal to 0 in N type material?
Because N type has donor.
Right. So N type is a donor. So only donors will be present. So it indicates that there will be an absence of acceptor. So that's why Na will be 0. The same thing is applicable for P type also. Here, as it is only acceptor, so therefore ND is 0 here. And can anyone tell me why N is greater than P in case of N type? What are majority carriers in N type material?
Electrons.
Right. So electrons are more compared to holes. That's why N is greater than P. Now you try to substitute these two conditions within this equation. So what we know, Na is 0. So therefore, this term gets cancelled down. Next, what we are saying is N is greater than P. If N is greater than P, we can neglect this P term. So that's why ND is something which is equivalent to N. So this term also gets cancelled down. Clear? Same thing is applicable for P type also. In P type, what we know, the majority carriers are holes. So P is greater than N. It indicates that holes are greater than
electrons.
Now you try substituting this equation. So here ND gets cancelled down. At the same time, N gets cancelled down. So therefore, we get Na is something which is equivalent to P or N.
P.
So it is equivalent to P. And you try to substitute this condition in this mass action law. And one more thing, why I'm considering the suffix N here?
Because it is N type.
So N type. Here?
P type P.
Okay. And what does this N mean here? These are electrons in N type, these are holes in N type, right? If you come here, NR, electrons in P type material,
holes in P type.
And good. So we have discussed this, and we have discussed about conductivity as well. These are some basic terminology. I think rule number one has revised all these concepts to everyone. So we have discussed about charge, current, and electric field as well. So this is an important formula which you need to remember at least. So electric field is something which is force per charge. Clear? And close to the atom, there will be strong electric field. And if you are moving away from this, there will be weak electric field. and these lines are something which we call as field lines. So at least you need to remember this formula, because you may get problems on this formula as well. And can anyone tell me what is the formula for VB, barrier potential?
KT by Kaga LN NA ND by NI square.
Good. So KT by Q into LN of NA ND by NI square. So what is NA?
Concentration.
Yes.
ND? Concentration of donors.
So I hope you are clear. And what should I do? I need to replace KT with? KT by Q with?
VT.
VT means?
Thermal voltage.
Thermal voltage. What is the value?
26? 26 million.
26 millivolt. Millivolt. So milli something which is 10 power minus 3 or minus 8. So milli means 10 power minus 3. Suppose if it is micro.
10 power minus 6.
10 power minus 6.
Good. If it is nano.
10 power minus 9.
Right. Nano means 10 power minus 9. If it is pico.
10 power minus 12.
Good. It is 10 power minus 12. So please make a note of this. What is meant by milli, micro, nano and pico? Mostly in labs you will deal with all these properties. So I hope you are clear. And what is the value for Boltzmann constant K?
1.38 × 10⁻²⁷ joules per Kelvin.
Good. And temperature?
300.
And what is the charge Q? 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹. Right. So you are clear with this concept. Next, we have discussed about this conductivity of semiconductor also. Can anyone tell me what does this VD mean here?
Drift velocity.
Drift velocity. Drift velocity is directly proportional to applied electric field. And here mu stands for mobility. I think we have discussed this slide also, right?
Yes, sir.
So in order to overcome this proportionality, we replace it with proportionality constant mu. Now as we want mobility, mobility is something which is Vd by E. And these are nothing but units of drift. And these are nothing but units of electric field. And current is nothing but NEA Vd. If you want current density, we need to divide it with area. So I by A. So A and A gets cancelled here. So what we get, J is something which is NEVD. Now you simply try to substitute this drift velocity here. VD is something which is equivalent to mu. So we got this one. And I'm saying that NE mu is something which is something called as conductivity sigma. So that's why we got J is equal to sigma E. This is one form of Ohm's law. Whereas what we know till now is V equal to I into R, right?
IR.
So this is, yes, good. This is one of the Ohm's law and this is also an Ohm's law. And rule number one, can you explain me why mass of a hole is greater than electron?
Sir, I have a doubt here only.
Yes,
about mass of hole and mass of electron. Sir, in the definition of hole, it is said that hole is the absence of electron.
Yes.
So how can mass of hole be greater than electron?
So have you found the value for this? What is the mass of hole and what is the mass of electron? Have you checked the value for this?
No, I didn't check it.
So better tomorrow you tell me again. You try to find the value of mass of hole and mass of electron so that you'll get to know about this concept. This is very simple, but I want you to try it. So
okay.
So according to now, I'm saying that mass of hole is more than electron. As we have discussed that the stone which is of 100 kg moves slower compared to the stone which is of 1 gram, right? So according to that, mobility of electron will be more compared to hole. You try to find out that why mass of hole is greater than mass of electron.
Okay,
so this is one of the important formula directly can use it while solving problems. So I hope we have discussed this slide also, and this is the slide that we need to start in today's session. So what is width of depletion region? So what we know till now, initially if we join p-type and n-type material because of charge gradient, what is happening?
Depletion layer is formed.
And it is because of charge gradient, and this is something which we are saying it as a depletion region. So this is having some width, so that's why I'm saying it as WD, width of depletion region. D stands for depletion, W stands for width. So this is a formula which you need to remember. And in most of the cases, actually this type of formulas are very useful while you are attempting gate. Generally you will write this exam in 4-1 or 4-2, and now you got the flexibility to attempt the same exam in third year itself. So while attempting this kind of competitive exams, you need to remember these formulas. But for theory and for university point of view, generally you won't get used to these formulas. So better to try to remember this formula at least. So width of depletion region is something which is equivalent to 2 epsilon by Q, 1 by Na, 1 by Nd, Vd. So in analog electronics, mostly formulas will be there. So at the end of each and every unit, you need to list all those formulas. So here, epsilon is something which is called as electrical permittivity. And you know this, I think. Permittivity of free space and relative permittivity. And these are some of the values for silicon and germanium. And you can see here, this is the amount of width. So generally, this width will be 1 micrometer. So micro is something, 10 power minus 3 or 10 power minus 6?
Minus 6.
So it is 10 power minus 6 meter. 1 micrometer is something which is equivalent to 10 power minus 6 meter. And this is the approximate range of this width of depletion region. This is the depletion region. Clear? Next, this is a formula. Generally, you need to use it while solving problems. For 2 marks, you'll get some of the problems based on this question. And however, you know about barrier potential VB, right? So the combination of barrier potential and ID is something you'll get to see in most of the problems. So here, diode current. What we have discussed is, we know about PN diode, right? So better, I'm trying to apply power bias. So P to P and N to N. So this is the voltage across diode. This is ID, current through the diode. So are you okay with the terms, right? Across and through. I've recorded one screen recording also by using some software. I'll show you in the next slide. So this is nothing but VD. So VD is something which is diode voltage. ID is something which we call as diode current. And this is a new term that you are hearing. What is reverse saturation current? So generally, you have seen these two terms in all the previous slides, right? VD and ID. So what is this IS? So if it is forward bias, it will act as a short circuit or open circuit?
Short.
Yes, please.
Short circuit.
If it is forward bias, it is in on or off?
On.
Short circuit is something which we call as on, right? So it will be something like this. So if there is a short circuit, will current flow through it or not? So current starts flowing through the diode. Then what is this reverse saturation current? What we know is diode is unidirectional or bidirectional in nature. Diode is unidirectional or bidirectional. What is uni and what is bi? Uni means from P to N only current will flow, only one direction. Suppose if current starts flowing from N to P, it is something which we call as reverse saturation current. So under forward bias, you will see this condition. Means current will flow from P to N. Whereas under reverse bias, depletion region starts increasing. So there exists a small amount of current. This is very negligible amount of current. This is very small. There will be a small amount of current when the diode is operated in reverse bias configuration. And here the current is because of minority charge carriers which are present within the depletion region. So if you see here, so what will happen under reverse bias? Will depletion region increase or decrease?
Increase.
What will happen? It will increase. Good. So under reverse bias, depletion region will increase. So if it increases, there exists a more amount of minority carriers in this depletion region. So because of it, there exists a electric field from positive to negative in this direction. So which constitutes a small amount of current, which we call as reverse saturation current. Is it clear? You have not seen this term in previous slide, whereas you know about this diode current and diode voltage. Whereas you don't know about the reverse saturation current, and this is a phenomenon. So when the diode is operated in reverse bias configuration, what we know is when a diode is operated in reverse bias configuration, there is an increase in depletion region width, right? So there exist more number of immobile ions within this depletion region. So suppose better, I'll try to apply the potential as well. So P to negative and N to positive. So here they will try to move in this direction. So this leads to an increase in depletion region, because of which there exists more number of carriers within this depletion region. So however, what we know, it will be current will be the direction from positive to negative. So because of which, from positive to negative in this depletion region, there exists some amount of electric field E, which constitutes a small amount of current, which is very negligible. Generally, we should not consider it, but for better practical cases, we need to consider small amount of reverse saturation current, which exists because of this minority carriers, right? Whereas diode current is something, because of forward bias, it acts as on switch. If it is on, generally current starts flowing from P to N. So however, I hope that you know about this concept, VD and ID, whereas you don't know about this reverse saturation current, which is generally operated under reverse bias. And we shall discuss what will happen. Please try to mute. And here VD is something which you call as threshold voltage, and value is 26 millivolt. We have discussed this in previous slide. And this is a new term, neta. Here neta is something, this is a value that you generally use. Suppose if for low current ID, for germanium diode N will be 1, and for silicon it will be 2. Whereas if current is more, then neta will be 1 for both germanium as well as silicon. So this is an important formula, at least you need to remember. And in the later stage, we'll try to derive this expression also in detail. Means how we got like ID is equal to IIS into e power VD by neta VT minus 1. So by using all the energy band diagrams, we need to derive this concept. So till now, for 2 marks, you need to remember this formula. Similar to barrier potential VB. So now you are able to tell me the formula for VB, right? In the same manner, you need to remember this diode current equation also. Clear? So these are VI characteristics. What is V and what is I?
Voltage and current.
Right. So voltage and current characteristics of PN diode. And in how many regions we have operated it? I mean, no bias. Next is forward.
Reverse.
Right. So in the 3 cases, we shall see how voltage and current characteristics in the form of graph. See, it is operated in 3 types, like zero bias, forward, and reverse bias. And this is something graph we need to plot. So generally, you know this. This is positive x-axis, positive y-axis, negative x, and this is negative y, right? So what I am doing is, on this x-axis, I am representing voltage. On y-axis, I am representing current I. Now we shall see under forward bias, how is a graph, under reverse bias, what is a graph, and under no bias. First, in zero external voltage, means zero external means something, it is no bias, means I am not applying any external potential to the diode. So no bias is something which we also call as open circuit in nature. So this is open circuit. See, when there is no voltage, will there be any current? What will be?
No.
Suppose
no.
Voltage is zero, current will be? No current. See. So that's why at voltage zero, current will be zero. It will be at the origin. Clear till here?
Yes.
No voltage, no current. And can you tell me what is the barrier voltage? Barrier voltage. So someone said that varied potential VB is something equivalent to KT by Q into ln of NA and D by NA square, right? So can anyone tell me what is barrier voltage?
The voltage required to start the conducting.
Good. So it is a minimum amount of voltage that is needed to start conducting. So for silicon, what is the value? 0.6. It is in the range 0.6 to 0.7 volt. For germanium?
0.3 volts.
Good. It is 0.3 volt. Now we shall see. So I've implemented this using multi-SIM software. And here you can see that YouTube link also. I've recorded this video and I've posted in YouTube also. So better you try to refer it. And in the future, you'll try to use this software for simulating purpose. This is multi-SIM. I've implemented the circuit using multi-SIM software. So in the previous slides, what I've told you, voltage across or voltage through? It is voltage across or through?
Across.
Right. So see here, this is the diode. As I'm connecting, we call this one as multimeter. This is multimeter, which is used to measure current, voltage, resistance. Everything can be done by using this multimeter. And under this also, there are two types of multimeters, basically, analog and digital. So generally, now for better purpose, we are making use of digital in our college also. You can see when you come to lab sessions, right? So as I'm connecting this multimeter parallel to this diode, this is something which we call as across, right? If it is connected parallelly, it is something which we are calling as across. Whereas what we know, current is something which flows through the diode. So just simply I've connected this circuit using multi-SIM software. This is something which is called as a battery, or else general term we call it as DC power source. So this is positive, this is negative. I'm considering 1 volt for this, and you can consider 5 volts also. And in series, I've connected diode, and this is a number 1N4007. Generally, we make use of this diode. So diode, across this, I've connected multimeter in order to check it's working, right? So better after the completion of the session, you try to click on this link so that it will show you the live working of it also. Means you can see this DC characteristics, DC transfer characteristics. So what you have said under x-axis, what I'm considering, voltage or current? On x-axis, voltage or current?
Voltage
on x-axis and current on y-axis. If you see here, which diode I've considered, silicon or germanium? How can you say? Is it silicon or germanium? By seeing the characteristics of graph, you need to identify whether it is silicon diode or else germanium. Can anyone guess it? Is it silicon or germanium?
Silicon.
Silicon. The barrier potential is in the range of 0.6 to 0.7. So that's why if you see here, from 0.6, this graph starts increasing. See, from 0.6, it is increasing. Increasing means current starts increasing when the minimum amount of voltage, that is 0.6 to 0.7, is provided, current starts flowing. So conductivity, in order to allow conductivity, there should be a minimum amount of voltage. So for silicon, it is 0.6. So same thing, you can implement with germanium as well. So is this forward bias characteristics or reverse bias characteristics according to the diagram?
Forward bias.
Why forward? Because?
Inverse.
Right. P is connected to positive terminal, N is connected to this is negative something connected here.
We are getting the heaven from.
So that's why this is configuration. Better you try to implement some more circuits like this by downloading. At least, because as you're having time, you try to experiment so that you'll get some doubt. You need to learn all the components which are present. So here I'm using the in the same manner, ammeter will be present. So better you try to explore this software once. How to download multi-SIM software. I've included this video also. Better I'll share that link as well. And these are forward bias characteristics of diode. So what will happen under reverse bias now? Under forward bias for silicon, this will be in the range from 0.6 to 0.7.
And there is lots of disturbance.
Yes?
There is so much
germanium, the minimum amount of barrier voltage is 0.3. At 0.3 starting.
Sir.
Yes, if anyone is having doubt, unmute and tell me. Any doubt in previous slide? Here. No more doubt, right? So this is the knee voltage from here to here. We can say this as knee voltage.
All this are
current starts increasing. Right? This is current. Next, if you see under reverse bias configuration, what will happen?
Sir, your voice is not clear, sir.
Is it okay now?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir. Is it okay now?
Lots of disturbance, sir.
Now is it clear?
Sir, mute.
Python on the screen. Any doubt? With Python?
First one.
Am I audible? Tanvi, could you please confirm?
Sorry, I'm audible, but there's a lot of disturbance, sir.
Because of fan, I think. College only. The environment is peaceful. Might be an issue, I guess. So is it okay now? Okay, we can see this slide. So are you going to wait after the complete completion? What is the barrier potential? Guys, please try to mute.
पूरे घर की आवाज आ रही
है. रोल नंबर 30.
यस, इट्स क्लियर नाउ.
Hello.
Yes, can anyone tell me what is barrier potential? Clear now, no issue. Yes, can anyone tell me what is barrier potential? Or else, what is the depletion region width? Kamla? Anyone? Square root 2 epsilon naught by Q into 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into Vb. Right. What is the formula for diode equation? Id equal to? Yes, anyone? Formula for diode equation.
Id equal to Is into Vd by
Neta VT. Minus 1.
One.
Good. Next. Under reverse bias, what will happen now? So we have seen in forward, now in reverse. So here V should be connected to the negative or positive. Under reverse bias, V is connected to negative and N is something which is connected to positive. So what will be the flow of current? Means is it from P to N or from N to P? what will happen here? Open circuit or short circuit? It open or short?
Sir, your screen is not visible.
Sir, your TV is not visible.
What is this rule number? Is it okay now?
Yes, sir. Your screen is not visible, sir.
I'll try to share the entire desktop. So here, once you open your Microsoft Teams, under this tabs, you can see that video also. Powered by characteristics of diode. I've pinned that video in this tab also. And at the same time, I'll share the link with you also. Better you try to download that software and try to experiment. So that at least you'll try to remember some of the component names at least. So diode current ID is something equivalent to IS into e power VD by Neta VT minus 1. And can anyone tell me what is reverse saturation current? What is reverse saturation current? Anyone? What is reverse saturation current? Are you able to hear, guys?
Yes, sir.
So what is reverse saturation current? Is it because of forward or reverse? Reverse bias.
Reverse bias.
Is it small or large?
Mohammad unko message kara aur lambda se
next question I won't tell you sir better try to read sun padhai hai aap mein bachche ki padhai dar se Mohammad try to better try to call him and inform are
saath jaane ke baad shaadi karna hai kaise bhai nal
Yes, what about the reverse current configuration? Can you tell me what is in reverse bias? P is connected to negative, N is something which is connected to positive. As I've told it, reverse saturation current is very narrow, which is very small. So if you see this diagram, there exists very small amount of current. So what we have seen is under powered bias characteristics after 0.6, current starts increasing. Whereas in case of reverse bias, there exists small amount of current like this. You see here. Sanvi, are you able to hear me?
No, sir.
Sorry, can you repeat again, sir?
One second.
Repeat one second.
You don't know how to use the interface or what? Roll number 30.
Sir, please mute him, sir.
I'm removing him directly from the meeting.
Again, he will come, sir.
I won't allow him to see now. So are you able to see the screen, right? No issue?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Better try to explain him how to use that interface. I think he might be new to this.
Yes, sir. I said to him, he has closed her microphone.
Knowingly or unknowingly, he's on unmute state, so better try to
estimate. He don't know, sir, how to close mic.
Yes, sir, that's what. Because his cam is also in on state only.
Yes, sir.
Yes, what are the reverse bias characteristics now? So under forward bias, what you have seen? Once if the voltage exceeds 0.6, current starts flowing or not?
It starts flowing.
Germanium, what is the minimum amount of voltage?
0.3.
So better you try to remember this concept also, because in the further chapters, you'll see in the next chapter only, in the second chapter under field effect transistor, you'll see the same term once again, like barrier potential, but there we call it as threshold voltage. We shall see that in the next unit, but all the first unit concepts are very important. So I hope you are clear with forward bias, right? So you know about silicon and germanium. So under reverse bias, if you see here, so what I've told you, reverse bias is something, it will be like this. So here P is connected to, yes, P type is connected to negative terminal or positive terminal under reverse bias?
Negative.
Negative and this is positive. So diode on or off?
Off.
So diode is in off state. Off means short circuit or open circuit?
Open circuit.
Open.
Open circuit.
Open circuit. But because of minority carriers, there exists a small amount of current. If you see here, this is a small amount of current, this gap actually. This gap is something, small amount of current exists. This is on negative axis, negative y axis. This is negative x axis. Why? Because P is connected to negative and N is connected to positive. So that's why this is negative voltage and negative current. And as the diode is in off, which is nothing but open circuit, but because of minority, there exists a small amount of reverse saturation current. You can see it here. So better, you see this graph. At minus 20 volt, there exists a small amount of reverse saturation current. At minus 40, some current. Minus 80, minus 60, and minus 80. So once if voltage is increased beyond a certain level, there exists a breakdown. So what we know is, under reverse bias, the depletion region will increase or decrease?
Will increase.
Under reverse bias, depletion region increases or decreases?
Increases.
Suppose, let us say, if it is at 80 millivolts, suppose. Bias thing is, if at 80, minus 80 millivolt, if this is the amount of depletion region, and if I'm trying to increase the voltage beyond certain level, what will happen? What will happen? If I try to increase the voltage beyond certain level, suppose the maximum voltage that it can withstand is, suppose say it is minus 80 millivolt. So if I try to increase beyond this, what will happen? The diode will get damaged, right? So it is something which we call as breakdown. If the reverse voltage is increased beyond a certain voltage, the diodes get breakdown. So therefore, there exists a more amount of current. Why? Because there exists more number of minority carriers within this region, because of which there exists an electric field. Therefore, current starts increasing rapidly, which we can't control it. Clear? So this is one of the important concepts under reverse bias. So can anyone repeat the same statement? Rule number one, what is happening in reverse bias? Can you explain?
Okay, so in reverse bias, the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the N region and vice versa.
Okay.
So here the depletion region will increase. So the minority carriers will carry the current, and the current will be very small.
Okay.
Okay.
So and what is breakdown?
As you keep increasing the voltage, there will be a certain voltage, the maximum voltage. A yes, a certain limit at which there will be no further current carrying.
Okay. So simply, if the voltage is increased beyond certain level, it enters into the breakdown region. So better you consider this voltage as reverse voltage, right? VR. Whereas for forward bias, you consider it as VF better. so that you can differentiate it. Forward voltage, this is reverse voltage. This is forward is something which is positive in nature, reverse is something which is negative in nature, as you can see it here. So this is one of the important 2 marks question. He'll try to ask you what are the VI characteristics of PN diode, so that you need to explain under forward bias, reverse bias and no bias. So you can try this experiment in multisim also. You can implement all the characteristics directly, you'll get the graph like this. Better you try to implement this. Suppose you take it for 0.5 volt and what is the output? Suppose if it is for suppose 1 volt, you try to increase the voltage in the range of 0.5. At 1.5, what is happening? At 2 volt, like this you try to implement using multisim, so that you'll see this graph directly, you'll get this DC graph, so that you can understand the characteristics easily. You can see here I've implemented only for silicon. In the same manner you try to implement this using multisim. Clear? Any doubt with this? Can I go to next slide, or any doubts with this? So in order to explain you that why voltage across and current through, I made use of the circuit, right? So we have discussed forward and reverse, and what is the effect of temperature. This is also one of the important question for 2 marks. So just now what we have seen, how are the characteristics of diode. If you see here, positive x axis, this is positive y axis, this is a negative x and negative y. Under x axis I'm considering voltage, on y I'm considering current. So these are forward bias characteristics. So are you able to see the screen? No issue, right?
Yes, sir.
Right.
So under forward bias, if voltage is increased beyond certain level, current starts flowing. So for this, suppose if we consider for silicon, after 0.6, the current starts flowing. Whereas these are reverse RB, reverse bias characteristics. There exists a small amount of minority current, but if it is increased beyond certain voltage level, it enters into the breakdown. So actually, there are 2 types of breakdowns, which we shall discuss while discussing with Zener diode. Generally, there are 2 types of diodes. One thing is we have discussed about PN diode, and next type of diode is Zener. So better we'll try to finish the complete all the concepts, including the applications of PN diode. Therefore, we can continue with Zener in next session. So first, you need to be perfect at least with PN diode, so that easily you can understand the Zener diode configurations. So these are some of the effects of temperature on VI characteristics. So I think it's 11:09, but I'll try to take the attendance. I'll try to download the attendance. But before this, you tell me what will happen if you try to increase the temperature beyond certain level under forward bias configuration. Mohammed, rule number one. You try to go to the slide and tell me what is happening exactly. So what we know under forward bias, if voltage is minimum amount of voltage, if it is 0.6, if it is greater than 0.6, current starts flowing. Now in this case, if I increase temperature, what will happen? We shall see. So better we shall discuss this in next session. It's almost 11:10 because next class will start. So please be online so that I'll download the attendance once. So guys, do you have any more doubts in today's session? Anyone? Tanvi?